Hello everyone, this is Kulit Subnekabay. Today I received a letter from my university that they will not accept students who stayed during the past 7 days before entering Taiwan, departs from and take a flight transit from level 1 to 3 countries on Taiwan travel notice. Taiwan had imposed a travel alert against Italy, raising it to code red. It was just last week when Taiwan imposed an import ban on light pigs as retaliation for imposing a travel ban on Taiwan, lumping the country as part of China. The recent deadly spread in Italy may have attribute from mishandling the first coronavirus case in a hospital in Codogno. Outside China, Iran has the most case of death, followed by Italy and South Korea. Iran had only 245 reported cases. The death amounts to 11%. It may be due to the poor health of the people caused by the ongoing war with Israel. The most alarming news is Iran may have more than these figures because the health ministry had told its officials not to announce any new statistics. Hospital resources say that there are already 210 deaths. In South Korea, the number of infected cases escalated to over 3,000, making it the most cases outside China. The government raised its alert status to code red after 500 new cases reported due to community spread, traced to a quasi-Christian cult where it encouraged Sikh followers to attend service and sit closely together. Officials are currently tracing that supporters who traveled from Wuhan, China, may have brought the virus when they attended the funeral of the founder's brother last month. Reports that members of the cult refused to be checked or quarantined, having more than 60% of the infected patients from the Diamond Princess cruise ship. Many are not impressed with how Japan government released its locals and let them return home without further quarantine. The US and the Philippines had imposed another 14-day quarantine to returning passengers. Days after the release, more than 50 passengers had developed coronavirus symptoms and tested positive. Thailand had less than 50 reported cases, but it is monitored because more than 20,000 visitors from Wuhan, China arrived in the country. While countries were imposing a travel ban on China, Thailand did not restrict Chinese tourists and even offered to travelers to stay in Thailand before flying to countries which impose a travel ban. Travelers from Wuhan, China may have traveled to multiple countries that has no travel ban, stay there for a couple of days or weeks, then enter another country without quarantine. I suggest that your immigration officers check previous travel records before granting them entry to your country. So, what measures are countries taking? Japan and Iraq have ordered schools to close. I actually got a job offer to Japan in September and hope it will be over by then. Saudi Arabia is stopping foreign pilgrims from entering the country. Iran had urged citizens to avoid making unnecessary trips within the country. Australia extends a travel ban on foreign visitors from mainland China. Italy has quarantined 11 towns. Greece is cancelling all carnival activities. Taiwan, an independent country, not a current member of WHO, has imposed strict measures to contain the spread of coronavirus. Taiwan government ordered a ration system for people buying surgical masks, a mandatory temperature check, and disinfectant before entering schools, restaurants, and other establishments. They prepared a separate quarantine facility that isolates infected patients and suspected ones. That is impressive. And yet WHO does not want to restore the membership of Taiwan. I think not being a member of WHO made Taiwan execute better measures to contain the coronavirus cases in the country. They have decided independently at the earliest time, showing that Taiwan is better than other members of the WHO. Meanwhile, a total of 400 plus Filipinos from the cruise ship are taken into the Philippines quarantine facility after arriving from Japan. None tested positive for the COVID-19 during their stay on the cruise ship. Though 9 showed symptoms, 7 had tested negative and the other 2 are still waiting for the test results. Among the countries with reported COVID-19 cases, Nepal, Cambodia, Sri Lanka, India, Philippines, the Russian Federation, and Belgium had no local transmission recorded in the past 3 weeks. These Asian countries had recovered except for one who died in the Philippines. Officials in the Philippines say that the patient was already not feeling well before he arrived from Wuhan, China. I'm sure there are many tourists from Wuhan who traveled to various countries last January. And despite having lower healthcare ranking, it seems that the COVID-19 is not spreading in these 5 Southeast Asian countries. This is a very important piece of information that the WHO and the CDC should look at. What do these countries have and why it was successful in containing the virus? Record shows that these Southeast Asian countries are not prone to colds because they do not experience winter. I know a lot of countries are also not experiencing winter like Australia, but these countries implemented measures earlier because they cannot afford if the virus spread in their country. COVID-19 is similar to SARS. Previous records of coronavirus SARS shows that it started in China in December 2002 and ended in June 2003. Look at the season. It began in winter and finally contained in summer. What I'm trying to say is, we can stop coronavirus from getting worse, given the special conditions. I developed a theory that may lead to finding the answer for the WHO and CDC. I hope you can share this to get their attention. First, coronavirus may be weak to a hot environment. Based on coronavirus SARS and MERS, it was completely contained in summer. I know that quarantine facilities have warmer temperatures compared outside. I was quarantined before, during the H1N1. The warm facility may have helped in the quick recovery of patients. However, after recovering and released, they were tested positive again after being exposed to cold weather. What do you think? Most of these Southeast Asian countries had its cases recovered already. I'm sure you will ask why other countries that had no winter are experiencing an outbreak right now. Because other countries did not implement strict measures earlier, some did not even impose quarantine or travel ban until the middle of February. But let's not look for faults. Let's find a solution to this problem. The second part of my theory, coronavirus may be able to survive in inanimate object for more than 9 days and become active when absorbed. It is already known that coronavirus is transmitted both direct and indirect contact. If COVID-19 has already spread earlier before the Chinese initial report to WHO and it already transmitted to everyone who traveled from Wuhan, China, and possibly transmitted to third or fourth exposure, then it would answer why new cases are emerging in countries with no recorded travel or contact from people who traveled from Wuhan, China. Patients in these new cases may have contacted a person who contacted another person who traveled from Wuhan. The virus may have transmitted person to person or through contact with an inanimate object. Why COVID-19 is spreading quickly now? Why it did not infect second or third exposure while infecting the fourth? The third part of my theory may answer this question. It is active and fatal to hosts with weak immune system. Coronavirus started in winter. People in cold places are prone to seasonal flu. Research shows that immune system in winter is at its weakest stage due to reduced in vitamins that help regulate the immune system and boost our body's natural defense against disease. Now is the time when the season changes and more people get sick during season change because the change in weather can weaken the immune system. If you think it's a baseless opinion, then why do doctors tell you something like, it is easy to get sick because the season is changing? Some people may look healthy but do not mean they have a healthy immune system. Viral infections can cause disease in humans, animals, and even plants. However, they are usually eliminated by the immune system. The stronger the immune system, the faster it could develop antibodies that may be able to destroy the virus. Examples of recovering from common viruses are smallpox, dengue, flu, and measles. Antibiotics have no effect on viruses, but foods and vaccines that improve the immune system may be used to patients who are tested positive of coronavirus. So you have to eat foods that boost your immune system, which may eliminate the coronavirus in your body. Citrus fruits or lemon, lime, grapefruit, calamondin orange or calamansi, red capsicum or red bell peppers contain twice as much vitamin C. Broccoli, garlic, ginger, and spinach may increase the infection fighting ability of the immune system. Yogurt. Look for yogurts that have live and active cultures like Greek yogurts. Papaya. A single papaya is loaded with 224% of the daily recommended amount of vitamin C in a single papaya. Kiwi and pineapple. And food supplements. I know it's not a real food, but let's be practical. Not everyone can afford all these foods given the factors that they may be expensive or out of stock. When you're outside, please don't be overconfident that people next to you have no contact with anyone who had contact with a person who traveled from Wuhan, China. It may be possible that the virus is in inanimate object and may survive over 9 days. Once again, self-protection must be done by everyone. If you haven't checked, I'll put a link on ways to avoid getting infected. Make sure to have a healthy immune system. Stay away from the crowd, especially if it's indoor. Be safe and thank you for watching.